We are here standing in front of Kubal, the only aluminium smelter in Sweden. Here is produced about 130,000 tons of aluminium every year. This film will mostly deal with the cast house operations, but we will start looking into the smelting process. It's where you process aluminium oxide into aluminium metal. We shall start here in the lecture room and look a little bit on the raw material that goes into the processes. The major raw material is alumina or aluminium oxide that comes into this plant in the shape of a white powder like this. And that is in the process dissolved in a bath, we call it. And in that bath consists of aluminium, or it consists of cryolite. Also looks like a white powder here, but in the actual process it's molten and has a temperature of about 900 degrees. Before the alumina comes into this process, it has been in the shape of bauxite that looks like this. And it is a mineral and contains about 50% of alumina. And this is not processed in this plant, but is it processed in other places into the oxide, which comes here. Another very important thing in this process is also the electricity. Here the electricity comes into the plant. You see here the current leaders coming in there, and it corresponds to about what 90,000 households use every year. And this electric current will then continue into the pot rooms and feed the different cells. Now we are in the pot room where the electrolysis process is proceeding. And here alumina or aluminum oxide together with electric current forms aluminum melt. The current that comes into the plant here is about 160,000 amps. And it goes through this so-called bus bar, or the bar in the bottom. But the voltage over one cell is about 4.5 volts. What we can see here is electric conductors where the current comes into the process, and it separates then up into, on each side of the furnace, it separates up into eight different anodes. Yeah, the current goes into the furnace through the anodes, and there the process goes on. And also from the top of the furnace, alumina is fed all the time, continuously. So in the process then, the electric current together in the bath forms aluminum melt that comes down on the bottom of the pot. And then later on from the bottom, the melt is sucked up into a ladle by the tapping track. Here we see an anode. This is a carbon block. And it's fitted to this steel piece here, and the steel goes over to aluminium. So this is what we actually see on the outside of the furnace, this aluminium bars. And here the current comes into the furnace, goes through the steel and down into the graphite block. The graphite block is then lowered down into the bath in which the current goes. And during the process, this carbon block is used, so it's consumed. So it means that after about 30 days it has to be replaced. So now these blocks are standing here, and they will be fitted into the furnaces as new anodes. Here we see some used anode blocks. And what we see here is that the carbon has been consumed, so now it's just a small piece of the carbon left. And we also see on top of here rests of the bath. And all these pieces here will be reused. The bath will be taken away and grinding down to new powder and fed into the furnaces again. And the graphite piece here is also going to be reused. Then this holder are stripped and it will be used in the new, fitted into a new block. Here we are in the cast house. And here the melt is cast into different ingots. Either rolling ingots or billets for extrusion. Here we are standing at the casting station for casting of rolling ingots. Here the melt comes out of the furnace here, and if we follow the launder here, and in the beginning grain refiners are added. Here in this case they are added in this shape, and they also added in the shape of a wire that goes down into the melt and dissolves. Then the melt continues into the degasser over here. The degasser works in a way that argon is bubbled through the melt, and that way it lowers the hydrogen content of the melt. And we can see the degasser unit over there. The melt comes out here, and then it goes down into the ceramic foam filter. So it's a filter that the melt has to go through, and then it comes out here and further on out into the table. And if you look here into the mold, we have a water chilled mold around here. And here is the bottom block. So when the casting starts, the melt comes in and fills up the block up to this level, and it starts to freeze at the wall here, at the mold. And then this block will be lowered downwards, and the ingot will form. Here we are standing at the casting table. Here we can see where the melt comes from the furnace, goes into the degasser, and then out on the casting table. Then on the casting table we can see the different holes where the melt goes down through the molds. Here we see the grain refiner wire coming down into the melt. It's dissolved here and it follows the melt. On top of the melt here we see an oxide layer. We can see the rocking here of the table. It's a gas bubbling through the molds that makes this rocking. It means that the pressure is changing all the time in a certain frequency. We can see the rocking on the top of the melt. The melt here is flowing under a very strong oxide skin. I can see how flexible and strong the oxide skin is when the melt is rocking on the surface here. Here we see the backside of a casting table. This technique is called the air slip technique. It means that air is pressed through a porous graphite ring, and we get the air film between the melt and the ring. So if we look closer here, we see the holes where the melt comes down, and here we see the graphite ring in which the gas comes through. And then beneath the graphite ring we have holes, and here water comes out. So the water starts to chill the ingot directly beneath the ring, and here we get a very fast solidification, which means that we have a solid material only about 15 centimeters below the mold. After the casting, the extrusion billet needs to be heat treated. It's called homogenization. In the background here, we see the homogenization equipment here, which is a big furnace in the background. And the furnace is about 580 degrees. The billet comes here through the track, and then they go also through ultrasound testing for cracking. If they are okay, they go on, and then they go into the furnace in the back part, and then it goes through the furnace for about 3 to 4 hours. It comes out, and then when it comes out they will be cooled down by fans, by air cooling. After that they are cooled by water, and then they go to the packing and the shipping. Now we are standing here just outside of the cast house, and here the finished product comes out, and here they are loading on tracks or trains for further transport to different plants in Northern Europe. Rolling ingots are transported to rolling mills, and the extrusion billets are exported to extrusion plants.